glad you guys are here. Go ahead and get started.
Okay, so what I'm going to do here is just get some cheese shredded up. I don't really measure a lot. I kind of just eyeball it. So I think that should be good enough. I'm just going to mix this together. And what I find quicker is just using a hand mix to blend it together. Okay, so I added in a lot more cheese for the filling, cream cheese and the Monterey and Colby cheese I was using because our kids actually all like jalapeno poppers. Sometimes I'll bake them in the oven, but this time around I'm actually going to fry them. Okay, now that we have all the jalapenos cleaned out and halved, I'm going to go ahead and stuff them with my mix. Okay, so now that they're all stuffed, I am going to go ahead and make the breading that I use to fry them up. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is take the jalapeno poppers that are stuffed, and you want to dip them in milk, and then dip them in flour, and kind of let them sit. I'm going to actually put that there. You kind of want them to dry out a little bit before you dip them into the breadcrumb mixture. So I'm going to go ahead and continue dipping these in milk and then flour and bring you back when I'm ready for the next step. Okay, now that these have had some time to dry, what I'm going to do is take the jalapeno poppers, dip them in milk, and then dip them into the breadcrumb mixture. And this is going to be the coating for them. I'm going to do that to all of these, and I will bring you back when they're coated. Okay, you guys, well, I had good intentions to make some homemade french fries, but it is really getting late. I'm also trying to make some freezer space, so it worked out great. My kids really do not care for tater tots that much. There's a handful of them, so just to have an extra side to go with dinner with our hamburgers, I have the jalapeno poppers coated, breaded, ready to go in the hot oil, and the oven preheating to throw some tater tots in, and I am going to get the hamburger patties made up. Okay, now my oil is hot enough, so in the meantime, I'm going to pop these jalapeno poppers in the oil for about 2 to 3 minutes. Till they're about a golden brown. Jalapeno poppers are absolutely delicious. I usually, like I said, bake ours, but we've been doing this the past couple times I've made them, and we really do like them. They're probably not the healthiest option, but they are delicious. Okay, it has been about 3 minutes, and these are such a beautiful golden color. They're just oozing with yummy goodness inside. Super simple to make, but we love these. It is definitely a favorite. Our kids love them. Look at that, guys. Just absolutely amazing. Dripping with the filling. Nice, crunchy outside, but just absolutely perfect inside. Love these. These are one of our favorite ways of making jalapeno poppers. Okay, now we are going to just form the patties for our hamburgers tonight. You add on just a little bit of salt. Thankful I'm growing thyme this year, so I'm going to get this washed up. I just picked it from outside. It smells, oh my gosh, so good. But I like to do some thyme butter when I cook my burgers. Okay, I got the thyme washed up, most of the stems out. It doesn't really matter because it's just going to be for flavoring the butter. I will say fresh thyme is just one of my favorite smells. It smells so good. So let's try to get these burgers cooked up. Thankfully, I have another cast iron here I'm going to start so the burgers can all be done at the same time. Thankfully, after having company last night, I made a ton. We have some delicious homemade coleslaw ready to go with dinner. Okay, so thankfully, we're eating through these pickles this summer. I had some watermelon left over from last night having our company over. I made a ton. I think I tripled our coleslaw. So I have a little bit of homemade coleslaw. This is like the best coleslaw, hands down. I hope to do a video on it during this summer, but absolutely delicious coleslaw. So we're gonna add that and get rid of this leftover and go through our pickles. Oh, this is a new jar I gotta open. But anyway, dinner is almost done. All right, guys, so this is what dinner for 8 kids and 1 mommy looks like. It is done. We have some cheeseburgers, some tater tots for the kids. Some want pickles, some don't. Some want jalapeno poppers, some don't. My husband is working late at his office, so I'm going to keep his stuff set aside for him. But anyway, dinner is done. It is Monday, and I'm excited to get food on the table. Better late than never. So anyway, I will see you guys tomorrow for Tuesday night's dinner. Okay, so it is Tuesday, and my son had baseball eating takeout in the car at my husband's trailer yard, and that is our fifth wheel that we need to get packed up for our next trip. So anyway, it was a blur of a day, and it's like 7 o'clock at night, and dinner did not happen tonight. So sometimes, no matter what your good intentions for a meal plan are, sometimes you just gotta roll with it. Hopefully the rest of the week goes smooth and we stick to the plan. Hey everybody, today is Wednesday. Yesterday we ended up having to get food on the go because my son's baseball game went a little bit later than it was supposed to. So we are going to do yesterday's dinner for today. Today is Wednesday, and we are going to do baked ziti, some vegetables, and I am about to make a loaf of Italian bread. So I already had the beef thawed for the baked ziti, so let's get started. Anyway, so I am just wanting to say it is okay if meal plans don't work for your family. I always try to have a plan, but there's a lot of days things just are kind of spiraling out of control, and sometimes we just need to switch things around. But meal planning at least gives you an idea of the foods you have on hand and the meals you can make with that. So I am going to let our bread rise for our Italian loaf for about 30 minutes. I have my oven set to proof bread, and I got some pasta going for our baked ziti. Make my own sauce for this, but I do have some marinara sauce I got from Azure Standard, so I'm going to be using that. Because I'm not making my own sauce, I'm just going to add in some onion and garlic to add in our pasta. Okay. Going to add on my provolone. My bread timer is done, so I'm going to get this baked ziti assembled and then get my bread loaf rolled out. Okay, so the baked ziti is over there. It is done. This bread, the timer went off about 10 minutes ago, but I wanted to kind of have everything done at the same time, so the bread only needs about 25 minutes in the oven, and the ziti needs about 30 minutes. So I'm just going to get my dough stretched out, and the oven just preheated, so I'm gonna pop the ziti in. Just rolling it up, pinching the seam, and tucking in the corners. This bread recipe is a staple in our house. I make this for our French toast casserole. I will do French bread pizza with this. I also have done like garlic, like a cheesy garlic bread. You can do so much with this. It's a super, probably one of the simplest, easiest bread recipes I use. And it takes really no time at all. So I'm just going to wash it down with some egg wash. And then I'm going to pop my vegetables in the oven so they're done at the same time. I'll probably put it in with the bread because I think they're the same temperature. But, yep, so I need to also thaw our meat for tomorrow. I'm going to use up the short ribs that we have. from our cow. So I'm going to get those thawed and I'm gonna do that right now while I put this in the oven. That is hot, but our Italian bread is done. I'm telling you right now, this is definitely better than the bakery. It's absolutely just delicious, super easy. Okay, the baked ziti is done, and also I think the vegetables are ready to come out of the oven as well. Okay, dinner is done. I made up my husband's plate over there. I have his bread on the cutting board. Guys, this bread is absolutely delicious. I cut it warm, so the texture is a little bit, you know, different inside, but absolutely gorgeous bread. It is delicious. You don't even need butter on it. It's just really yummy. So anyway, his bread is on the cutting board, and oops, I forgot a plate. Anyway, it is time to eat. We are getting the table set, and everyone is coming to the table. Some kids are still showering and washing up from playing outside today. But anyway, that's dinner. Baked ziti, vegetables, and Italian bread. I'm going to do some barbecue short ribs with some baked mac and cheese and vegetables for tonight. So a problem I'm realizing is I only have one Dutch oven this size. And I need another one because I have to double it for our size family. So kind of a little bit of a problem right now. The only other thing I have is this, which is not going to work. It's not even big enough. So I think I need to order another one of these. Now, when I did a kitchen video the other day, and I linked some things that were in my kitchen down in the description for Amazon. And when I did that, I noticed these are actually on sale right now. These are the Lodge porcelain enamel type cast irons. This is the lid for it, but these are phenomenal. And I know, no, it's not dinner time for you guys. These are phenomenal, but I only have one I paid full price for. So it is like super cheap. I think it's like almost 50% off right now. So if you guys don't have one of these are amazing. I do like different breads in it with the lid in the oven, different Dutch oven style breads, which are incredible. So I'm probably going to get one or two more of these just because I only have this one. So I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to use this one, I think, which I think is like a outdoor camping style one. But it's going to have to work. I have a gas range at least, but these handles don't want to cooperate and go down. Anyway, that's what I'm doing right now, is just browning the short ribs, and then I'm going to make some barbecue sauce to go with it. Okay, my daughter's unloading the dishwasher because nobody even did that today. And I need all the kitchen space I can get. So these are already browned up. And what I'm going to do is add my water. And then go ahead and cover this. So because I got to double it, let me, hold on. Okay, actually, I need to, I forgot, I need to bring this to a boil first, then reduce the heat, so I'm jumping ahead here. What I did find down in our mechanical room was this, like, massive Dutch oven. It's a Lodge one. It's huge, but it's got, like, the feet on the bottom, so once again, I think made for camping, but I'm going to have to use it, so the way I have it arranged on the stovetop, the claws, the feet on it are just kind of in between the bars of my gas range, and it's just going to have to work for now because this is all I have. So I'm going to oil this up actually a little bit more and just use this. That's really all I can do till I get another one. But I actually could have done both sets of them in here and only had one dish, so I might swap that out and do that because I need this burner for a mac and cheese. I just shut my thing off. So I'm gonna go ahead and just get these in here. And get these ribs browned. Okay, anyway, I kinda have to wash the floor. I didn't realize the package was dripping blood everywhere as it was thawing. So anyway, I'm going to get these short ribs browned up, and then I am going to go ahead and switch it all into this pan because I really need the other burner to do my macaroni and cheese. I'm doing bake tonight. I have box, but I really don't like using that at all. That's like for lunches and like convenience type things during the week if we need something. And I forgot to make bread for sandwiches. So, and baked mac and cheese is delicious. So I don't do box for dinner ever unless I absolutely have to. So I'm going to get these browned up. All right, got these browned up. I'm going to take the broth since I'm doubling it and just pour it from this and add a little bit more. I think I have 6 pounds. 6 pounds of the short ribs. Usually you would do about 3 to 4 pounds, but I do have 6. So I'm going to actually add in maybe a little bit more water and get these boiling and then cover them. And then we are going to make our baked mac and cheese. Okay, there's something in the yard, so I need to go see. We've had a lot of bears around here. So that came to a boil. I'm going to reduce the heat. And we are going to set a timer for about 1.5 hours. This is definitely going to be a later dinner again. I'm not managing my time very well these days. Okay, so I got another package in, but I think I already know what this is. Line when I get that paper towel holder. And of course, you know, Amazon's always like recommended for you. And it's like, oh, I wonder what it could be. So the shelf that I got years ago from Hobby Lobby, Black Forest Decor, actually has a new sharper knife. Anyway, what was recommended for me, I saw and I'm like, oh my goodness, that's the same bears that we got from Hobby Lobby on the shelf in our son's bathroom. So this, they sold online and I bought it. It's also our guest bathroom, but it's our 5 little boys because their bedroom's right there next to the bathroom. But anyway, this is what it is. So you'll see in a second, I'll put it in there. This shelf, like I had no clue Hobby Lobby sold stuff from Black Forest Decor, but that's exactly like what's on the shelves in their bathroom. Let's go try it out real quick.
Okay, so are any of you really bad like me as far as not looking at measurements when you order online? That's within reach up there. So this is probably like 2 feet tall. But I looked in their catalog and all their toilet paper holders are that tall. So it's low. It's cute because it goes with their shelf that I got. So the way I look at it is we have 5 boys. So our oldest. So I look at it as like Caleb, Jacob, the twins. And they're because these bears are both the same size, just like our twins. And then Joshua being the littlest one. So that's the way I look at it. And it's kind of the same look. So I'm going to keep it and we'll just have to drywall patch that. But this is their bathroom. I don't think I've ever showed it. My husband did all this, redid it all. It was all ugly blue tile when we moved in. So he did it to match our travertine that we have throughout the house. I need to have some humor sometimes. This is my favorite. A temporary sanctuary for overwhelmed parents seeking refuge from their offspring. So didn't pretty anything up, as you can tell probably. But anyway, yeah, that is their bathroom. So anyway, cute little bear theme going. This is one of my favorites too. Bear bottoms welcome here and just a little rustic-y.
I make my barbecue sauce for this specific recipe and I ran out of brown sugar. So I'm going to take you guys along. If you don't know how to make brown sugar, it's super easy. And usually if I'm really in a rush to get dinner going like this, I don't take my time to refill it. Like I just did in my video of my kitchen and kind of reorganizing and decluttering it. Sometimes I have a really bad habit of putting things away empty. And then I really am annoyed with myself when I really need it and I'm in a hurry. Like tonight, I barely had enough brown sugar for this barbecue sauce. So with that being said, I'm going to take you guys along and show you how to make brown sugar. It's super easy. All you need is 2 ingredients and literally 2 minutes, not even 2 minutes. Maybe 2 minutes. It's simple. So I'm going to get this garlic chopped up to go in the barbecue sauce. Probably not even as fine as I really want it to be, but I'm in a hurry. I got to get that baked mac and cheese going, and I need to get this on the stovetop because the sauce has to simmer for about 1 hour at least. And then I have about exactly 1 hour left on the short ribs. So with that being said, I need to really speed it up. I feel like during the summer, oh my gosh, I can't get it together. It's like, there's really not a ton of routine because like I said, we're not really homeschooling like we would throughout the year. We're just like doing it when we can fit it in. And just like I said, finishing up history and science in another video. So not even like homeschooling full on, but my day can slip away from me very easily in the summer. And before I know it, it's like 6 o'clock and it's dinner time and I have not even started dinner. And yeah, so usually dinner time is a chaotic time. So doing a what we eat in a week, yeah, it could be simple, but it's not as beautifully orchestrated as you see some YouTube videos out there. Calm, you know, they got the piano music going in the background and, you know, slowly and carefully chopping stuff up. And it looks really nice and pretty, but I'm like, no, that can't, I don't know. That's not my life. My life is like, hurry up, dinner time, kids are hungry. And it stays lighter longer in the summer, so it really can pull a fast one on me because I'm like, oh, look, it's still light out. Oh, what time is it? Oh, 5:30, 6 o'clock. Yep. There's a lot to do. There's not enough hours in the day to do everything in between the animal chores and kids and cooking and doing my to-dos and whatever. It's just, I feel the day can really slip away from me. Anyway, I have these little things. It's covered in brown sugar right now, but these are amazing little ceramic things that you put in. Well, you wet it, you put it in warm water. Usually I'd rinse it off, but I'm trying to stay on the camera here. But you just let this little guy soak for about 20 minutes in warm water, and it keeps your brown sugar from drying out. Mine has never dried out. If you look at the last remaining bit that's on the bottom, I mean, it is like really moist, really moist. So to make brown sugar, if you don't know, I had to bust open a big 50-pound bag of sugar because my sugar bucket's empty, so I gotta fill it up. So anyway, you're going to take, I don't got a good shot, I'm sorry. I had to move my tripod, my whole thing like collapsed and I had to rig it. Ellie, go lay down. So anyway, what you want to do, well, you do your measurements for you, but to fill up a 1 gallon container like this, we're a large family, I don't like to make this all the time. I like to have a good amount on hand. So what I do is do 8 cups of sugar. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you got your 8 cups of sugar. I don't even level it out. I don't really care or have the time to. So do 8 cups of sugar and I do 1 cup of molasses. I do the old fashioned, as you can see, it's a mess. I need to wipe that container off because now it's sticking to everything in my other room. And I need a spatula. Hang. Oh shoot. No, I got it on the, what do you call it? Come on. All right. I got it on my attachment thingamajiggy. Okay. So anyway, scrape every bit out. So like you can make darker brown sugar or just the light brown sugar based off how much molasses you use. I just do a regular light brown sugar all the time, even with my gingerbread cookies or molasses, and that's it. So, and then get your paddle attachment. You could do this by hand with like a mixer, but I feel it just doesn't incorporate that well or quick enough like it would if you use a KitchenAid. You lift it up. Sorry, I don't know how close I am to the camera here. Lift it up and literally just beat it real quick. You're gonna wanna keep your spatula because you're going to, sorry about that, you're going to want to lower your bowl and scrape it down a little bit more. Can be super quick, doesn't matter. Just till it's incorporated and then bam, done. I like to kind of shake it off the thing, off this paddle attachment. And then that's it, guys, brown sugar, that's what it is. I have not bought brown sugar for I don't know how many years. I just make it myself along with a bunch of other kitchen staples. So if you'd like to see a video on that, I can do that. Actually, I think I'm going to do it regardless because I think a lot more people are interested in cooking themselves these days and doing things themselves and not being reliant on the store. So if you need to do it yourself at home, you'll at least know how. But this is the best brown sugar. I know, even though it's the same ingredients, but like from the store, I feel like it always dries out. It is just beautiful,
that's focused in. Absolutely beautiful. And it is like so moist, you can see it on your fingers. So my hands are clean, by the way. So I am going to get this in here. I usually let this little guy soak for about 20 minutes. And then it holds the moisture, and then you pop it down in the middle of your brown sugar, and it keeps it perfectly moist. Okay, I scrubbed up my bottle of molasses, washed my hands, and now I'm inserting the little ceramic bear into this, and voila, done. Brown sugar, it's topped off at least good enough for me. And my tripod is not wanting to cooperate whatsoever today. I don't know why, but anyway, I'm going to let this simmer for about 1 hour. I try to start and I'm missing my spoon rest. Hold on, I'm missing my spoon rest, so I need to get out my backup. Anyway, so I can put this away. I'm like trying to pick up my mess as I go along. That's the only way my house stays clean. So I'm getting water boiling for the mac and cheese. I'm out of burner space, you guys. This is taking up like two of my burners, going into my third middle burner. It's so big and I can't snap you back enough without breaking my tripod. So, anyway, I'm just trying to get this to boil. And as soon as it does, I'm going to drain the pasta, pull it off, start my cheese mix. I'm super picky. I love everything being done at the same time. And I do whatever it takes to coordinate that to make it happen. So that is what I'm in the middle of doing here. But yeah, so just want to take you along. Don't want to make this a super long video. But seeing some people do really short ones, voiceovers, and some people do lengthier ones where they chat and talk. And I like to get to know you guys, so I like to talk through some of them. Some of them I do like doing quick, but some like this, I'm like, I can just chat with you while I do this. So anyway, I'll be back. Okay, I did all my dishes minus that lid. So now I'm going to add my pasta in for a couple minutes and then clear this space. So, oh, I thought my tripod almost just fell. Oh, my cat knocked a box over for me opening a package. Almost knocked my tripod over with it. That would have been a sight to see. No, take her out. He's trying to fit in the box. Hang on. Okay, so I just need a few minutes on this. My other timer is occupied at the moment, so I'm going to put my timer on for that. Get this pasta cooking. The barbecue sauce is still cooking away. I'm going to make a pitcher to a sweet tea. We haven't had it for a while. Love it. The best sweet tea recipe in the whole entire universe. If you'd like to see it, put it in the comments below. I'll go off popularity vote for that because some people might see it and have a panic attack with the amount of sugar in it, but it is sweet tea. We do that occasionally, so I'm going to go whip that up real quick. Okay. Pasta's going. I can't even make sweet tea because I have no room on my stovetop to fit my tea kettle, so I'm going to have to heat up my water in mason jars in the microwave. Do you guys oil your water for pasta too? I've noticed a lot of people just do salt, but I put oil in my water with my pasta, but I haven't seen a lot of people do that, so anyway. All right, let's heat some water up. Okay, so I am in a hurry to get this going. I did realize that my stovetop was a little too busy, so what I did is put water in the microwave. That's going for the sweet tea. The short ribs have about 30 more minutes. My sauce, I'm trying to get it to cook down because I really needed tomato paste, and I'm actually out of tomato paste, which I don't know how that happened. So now what I'm doing, so I got my pitcher here for sweet tea, and then I need half a cup of chopped onion. So I left the onion out for my barbecue sauce. For that reason, I don't have my microphone on, so I'm kind of yelling. Make sure you guys can hear me. I don't want to move the tripod anymore. I have it in a perfect spot, so I just angled it differently. Anyway, I'm chopping up the onion now for the mac and cheese. If there's any videos you want to see on the foods that I made this week with the recipes, go ahead and leave that in the comments below and let me know, and I can do that for you guys and make a video sharing some of the recipes. So just let me know if you want to see any of those. But in the meantime, I'm just going to chop up this onion, and then I had to get my milk out. Had to run down to the garage because we're out of butter up here, which is kind of weird.
I've not really stocked up our like fridges and canisters, so I'm glad I did the kitchen clean the other day because it gave me a chance to fill stuff up that's been sitting empty. But anyway, I got my half cup onion and I got my butter melting. Okay, so this sauce is really starting to thicken up a lot. I'm actually going to lower that a lot. My water's ready for my tea. I'm not ready for that. I'm going to add in my onion for the mac and cheese. And I need one of my thingamajiggies over here. But I need to lower that heat. That is like super hot. Let me grab my water. Pour my tea. All right. Got my timer going for my sweet tea. I do like to, I know people out there are probably like, you know, I don't know about dinner. I feel nowadays a lot of people just don't have a lot of time in their day. And I feel like it's really easy for people to want to, you know, rush around during dinner time. It is always a crazy busy hour come dinner time in this house for sure. Let me measure out my salt real quick. Hold on. One half, and then I need 1 teaspoon of my ground mustard. Okay, anyway, yeah, dinner time is chaotic in this house, but I always try my very best. I know I've seen comments in the past, but I really do try my hardest to make a fresh meal every night for our dinner. I think that's just, I mean, that's the way I am. I like cooking. And I'm home anyway, although it is chaotic, but I don't mind. My husband likes having a fresh meal every night, and that's one thing I do. Very rarely do I do freezer meals. The only things I really freeze will be like a lasagna. Sometimes when I'm making one, I'll make two, or like a tray of enchiladas. But most of the time, the only thing that I will freeze from time to time is breakfasts, like quick ready-to-go things, or like a baked oatmeal casserole or a French toast casserole, things like that. But I feel dinners, I don't know. I've never really been satisfied with the results, but I know people have mentioned before, like, you know, to save time to just do freezer meals. But me personally, speaking completely for myself, I just, I'm home anyway. And yeah, it takes a little bit of time, but it's worth it. It's nice to have a nice hot, fresh cooked meal. So that's one big thing I do try to do for my family. I am spilling milk everywhere. I'm like really sloppy tonight. It's only because my camera's on. But anyway, yeah, some things I've just realized do not freeze very well, do not thaw very well. And it just, I don't know. So yes, I do cook my meals fresh just about every night, unless like Tuesday you saw that last minute I had to take my son to practice and didn't have enough time to make dinner because I was doing a video and kind of lost track of time and totally forgot to start dinner sooner. So anywho, life happens sometimes, but anyway, so I'm gonna give that a quick stir. I'm gonna let this come to a boil and my timer's on for my sweet tea. This, the short ribs still have about 22 minutes. I'm just gonna take a quick peek in, really quick peek in. Oh yeah, woo! Steamed you guys and me. Sorry, they're good. They smell delicious. Oh, they smell really good. They're gonna smell even better with this barbecue sauce. I'm trying to let it cook down because I didn't have tomato paste. I only had puree on hand, so letting it cook down a little extra longer, but everything should be done on time. We're moving along. I just need to get some veggies. I'm trying to make freezer space, so I'm gonna take some frozen vegetables out of my freezer, see if I have any left. Trying to use that up and get rid of freezer space and then just have my vegetables canned. That's my goal this fall. I am gonna have to buy in bulk. I can't, you know, grow every single vegetable we eat or enough to even feed our family for like a week. We don't have that set up yet, but I am gonna buy in bulk and can up some of our own things this fall. So while this comes to a boil, I'm gonna grate some cheese. Okay, this has started coming to a boil, so I'm going to dump all the cheese in that I'm using for this. which I usually use two different types of cheeses, but I only have one right now. It'll work. Okay, now I'm going to give this a stir, and then I need to get my black pepper because I forgot to add in my black pepper to this. So, actually I have some right here. I usually grind it fresh, but I don't feel like going to the other cabinet. Just use what I have in front of me. And then, there we go. So, the tea will be done in 3 minutes. It'll be completely done being brewed. And I'm going to dump my pasta in the dish. Okay, so now I am going to dump my, that could have been really bad. Dump my mac and cheese in here. My handle's a little loose. I need to tighten it. We got our mac and cheese in the 13x9. Kind of burned myself a little bit on that one, but I will take one for the team. That would have been our dinner ruined instantly. So, anyway, I got my oven preheating to 350. All right, mac and cheese is in the oven, and the dishwasher just stopped, thankfully, because I'm going to do my hand washing, get the dishwasher unloaded and reloaded, and dinner should be done by the time I am done all of that and wiping down the counters. So I will see you back when it's done. Okay, so the short ribs have cooked for an hour and a half. Trying to focus that, but it's not gonna work. So now I'm going to pour on our barbecue sauce all over and then cook them a little while longer, and then it will be dinner time. So if I can get it all out, there we go. All right, so these guys are gonna hang out in here for an hour. Okay, I'm getting them all covered in the barbecue sauce. It smells so good. I'm excited to get our, we get our second cow in a few days. We got one back in February. Oh yeah, this like fall apart tender. We got one in February, but I really want to be topped off for the winter. I think there's a lot of weird things going on with our food also. If you stay awake to those kind of things of what's going on, you already know. So I'm like, no, you know, we'll do whatever we can. We have chickens and ducks and turkeys and rabbits, but you know, we don't have a cow. So I'm like, we're buying local. I want to know what's in our food. I don't know what my son's doing. I don't know what he's doing out there. But anyway, I'm going to get this covered and lower the heat and simmer it for another hour. Do you hear that? My son's in the shower with the door open, apparently. One of my little sons. He's singing something. I don't know. But anyway, I got these hand wash dishes drying. Dishwasher's reloaded. I'm going to wipe down my counters and we're hungry. We're ready for food. Okay, so my husband, it looks like, is installing the gate on our fence, which is good. He got the gate, so it looks like him and four of the little boys are out there trying to get that assembled. My other son's in the shower getting washed up for dinner. That's what's going on right now. All right, it looks like my husband brought home two packages. We just, as of this past Christmas, those are on Christmas time, we got subscriptions for our kids. I've wanted to do the meal science forever. This is not a sponsored video, but just sharing with you while I'm opening it. They have different kits, alternative energy, and then the thing that goes with it. And then my dogs love these boxes. And Ellie, come here, what is this? He's my husband outside putting the gate down. Ellie, what's this? Anyway, they get their bully box once a month, and they get their treats. Copper's sitting well-behaved. Ellie is not, but it's like some kind of Egyptian theme this month. I got a little mummy, but it keeps them occupied, and that's good. So there they go.
Good, go get it, go get it.
Ribs are done. All right, dinner is done, and that is what it's looking like tonight. Didn't have time to get frozen vegetables out. Almost everyone's at the table, but there we go. So that is dinner tonight.
Okay, well, it is Friday. I'll be celebrating tomorrow. We leave tomorrow for Nebraska, and I need to get dinner going in the slow cooker right now. I'm praying my son's baseball game is canceled today. We had a ton of rain and hail. It's like 50 degrees outside. Yeah, it's sweater weather right now. It's like 50 degrees outside, really damp and yucky weather. I'm hoping the field's wet enough and they cancel it, but we need to be leaving in 30 minutes. So if I don't get an email within 30 minutes, we have to go because it's at least a half an hour away. So anyway, I'm doing our dinner tonight. Super quick, easy. Let me back you up a little bit. So I'm just dumping some chicken in. I'm doing like a cowboy style chicken in this slow cooker, and I need to open these guys up. I just have a jar of salsa. Oh, oops, wrong thing. I had a jar of salsa I'm going to be throwing in here. If my jar opens, there we go. So I got some salsa. And then I'm going to open up these black beans and corn real quick. Okay, I drained our black beans and I'm just dumping them in real quick. And our canned corn. And that is it. I'm going to put this, well, with the hour it is now, I probably should just pop this onto high. I probably should give this a quick stir. But that's it, high to 4 to 5 hours at least. And that's about it. When, oh, that is hot. I forgot I was preheating it and I just touched the ceramic part there. But anyway, I'm just going to give it a mix and then I'll add a brick of cream cheese and shred the chicken when it's done. So really simple. I wanted to film, oops, hold on a minute. I wanted to film today, but it's just one of those days. I feel like when our little kids, our little boys know when we're going somewhere, I don't know, that sometimes they just get really out of control, and that's kind of how today's been. So I'm a little burned out. I'm a little tired today, but they have been like walking around trying to pack their own clothes. I'm like, I will do it later this evening after dinner, and just constantly having to tell them to stop and put everything back in their dressers. So it's been a long day. Sorry for the rant, but, and they've been like extra fussy with each other. And right now I'm like, just play in your room. They really wanted to go outside and they have all the energy in the world, but it's just muddy and yucky out. Hold on. Anyway. It's yucky, it's wet out, it's cold, and it's just one of those days. It's one of those days that all of us moms face at some point in time, and yeah, I'm tired. So I usually serve this over rice, and that's what I do with this. I'll try and show the after. I've got to get everybody ready because they haven't canceled the game yet, so hopefully they don't change it last minute. I don't think they realize how far we live, and if they cancel it, it's like super short notice where we're probably already have left our house. So, and then I'm going to pack. I'm going to try and get a video in if I have enough space on my camera because I just did two pretty lengthy videos that I'm going to edit down, but they're lengthy, so they're taking up a lot of my space right now. And if I could get those uploaded to the computer quick enough, I plan to do a quick little like pack with me and just last minute tidy throughout the house. Laundry room's done. My daughter, Gracelyn, she's awesome. She just did the pantry, the rest of it for me. I did a late night like kind of hangout video with me, and I only got to do a little bit of the pantry. So she just finished off the rest. Thank goodness, because it needed to be done. I just like coming back and having everything kind of done. It's going to get crazy when we get back. We have at the fire department, I have a pancake breakfast coming up that I'm going to have to go to. I have a joint training day with a couple different fire departments in different districts around us. I have a lot. I got to study at some point for Fire Academy. I got this like super thick book that I need to kind of look over. It's just exterior that I'm doing this summer for August and September, so nothing insane like interior, although exterior I'm sure comes with its own things. But anyway, so it's dinner. This is a dinner video. I'm gonna stop ranting, just want to kind of catch up a little bit and talk to you guys, you know, so I can get to know you guys through the comment section and you guys can kind of get to know me a little bit better. But I need to go deal with this fussiness. I'm gonna go swap laundry, start getting shoes dug out and ready to go, and kind of work on my car for a few minutes. So I hope to do some kind of video today. I really want to, other than this. So anyway, I'll see you when dinner is done and we are either back from the game or we are just here because it got canceled. Guys. I shut my video off because I'm like, I'm not even gonna pause it. I'll just, you know, do a separate clip later. And I checked my email. Okay, prayers answered super fast. They canceled it today, so I'm so happy because I really need the time to be getting stuff done around the house, get my car ready for the trip with all the kids in the car. And I got some new trash bag holders for my car I gotta put in, so I'm just excited to have some extra time to focus on the house and getting things ready and getting instructions written out for my friend who's gonna be watching our animals while we're gone twice a day. Also, I got some exciting news. I'm excited over everything. Any babies, I'm like all lit up about, if you can't tell. But my friend who's watching our animals actually texted me and said her friend's son has an apartment in town and has two Cayuga ducks that are like 5 weeks old and he can't keep them. I'm like, it's an apartment. Of course he can't keep them. Why is the guy got ducks in his apartment? I don't know. We've had chickens in our living room and laundry room for like 3 months. So they were in the breeder, but there's ducks and chickens that make their way into our house on a daily basis. My daughter will just walk in here with chickens and ducks, and that's normal. You're a crazy chicken lady if you have chickens full grown that hang out in your house sometimes. They don't walk around, but they're in our house. But anyway, so there's two Cayuga ducks, and she's like, can you take them in? I'm like, you know, I can't say no. I can't say no to things like that. I have a problem. So anyway, we got two Cayuga ducklings coming when we get back from Nebraska. So I definitely need to cool a lot of our chickens because I need to get my ducks in a row. I really do. No pun intended. I need to, like, have how many chickens we need. How many, you know, ducks we want to have. The turkeys are all situated. I still don't know the sexes of them, but I have five. That's the only ones that made it. And I have an older hen out there, the Kentucky Bourbon Red turkey. So we'll see what the sex is, but I'm hoping to have a couple hens and a tom at least out of our surviving turkeys from McMurray Hatchery. If I didn't say it in a video, we had 15 of them and 10 of them died. That was very weird. They did say that they're a little more fragile, but we did everything to the T and they died nonetheless. So two were dead on arrival, but the other eight just died within like 48 hours, 72 hours. So don't know what happened there, but not cool. All right, I'm going to end this now that I got some time, clear up some space on my camera and try and get a video in. Sneak it in here now that dinner is going. Praise God, the slow cooker is cooking it. That's what I love about my slow cooker. I don't do many slow cooker meals, but I do love when I do because it cooks itself and it frees up my time. Oh, game's canceled. They canceled it because of the rain. He's not happy about it, but I'm going to miss my friend Michelle that I was going to meet up there, and we were going to get our kids together and hang out and chat during the game, but there'll be other times, so maybe we'll just do a play date here. What? Oh, okay. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, this is cooked through. Actually, it's a little bit overcooked because I kind of forget about it. I'm trying to edit a video, and then I realized that I accidentally deleted a part of it, so I'm trying to redo the whole thing again. This editing thing, it really can be difficult at times, which is frustrating because I had it like uploaded on YouTube doing the final edit and then realized my first editor I use, that's where I deleted it. So now I have to delete it off of YouTube, redo it on my original editor before I can redo all that again. So, and I need to get my cream cheese real quick. You're supposed to put the cream cheese in like 30 minutes before it's done. I'm sure it'll melt in this in no time because this is really hot. But the last 30 minutes of cook time is supposed to be when you add your brick of cream cheese. But oh well. Okay, so I'm uploading my video and realize I accidentally deleted part of it. I think I said that. I don't know. But I paused this to come back. The rice is just about done, and I was supposed to do a vegetable with this, so I'm probably going to have to do canned. I was hoping to do frozen yet again, but didn't happen. I'm still packing. I have the three little boys to still finish packing for. All my laundry is done. I am going to, after dinner and after I get the little kids in bed, I am going to do a video. I think I cleared enough space. I have a little bit of time left on my camera where I can just kind of do a quick little video. So it's going to be a little clean with me. I don't know what I'm going to call it yet. It's just going to be a mix.
Ben is not here. He is getting the fifth wheel jacks ready to go tomorrow so we can load up. So his dinner set aside. But anyway, this is what it is. I was going to do a vegetable on the side, but I'm like, you know what? It's getting late. We're tired. And we already had a little something before dinner, so this has vegetable in it. It counts. Just some cowboy chicken over rice. That's what we got going on tonight.